So while there were major concerns about birth pressure here in Canada regarding this subject matter, Activision on the other hand thought that they were doing God's work, man. And a ton of people are in the recovery stage. They are trying to recover. They were disappointed. Now they accepted, and now they are recovering from that disappointment because the Christmas update didn't do anything. Today we got a New Year's update, and this one is gonna get people wild in, man, because trust me, I've seen a lot of heat. So if you were recovering, seriously, don't watch this video. But hey, we got a New Year's update, and let's just get right into this update. Like always, we're gonna stay on top of Black Ops 4, so absolutely subscribe. I'm gonna keep you guys in the loops. Now, first of all, obviously, we got double XP in multiplayer, double XP in zombies, double merits in blackout, and double weapon XP for zombies and multiplayer, which is good. I just wish that there was also Nuketown 24/7. That would have been just much better, if you know what I mean. But man, I'm loving Blackout a lot. I believe that the reason I'm liking this a lot is because of the fact that they got armor up here, things going on. I know at first I wasn't really super keen on that, but now after going through it, it's looking really good. And on top, what kind of made this a banger for me was the fact that they put camos in Blackout. I just still wish we had diamond camos, even though I don't even have a single diamond camo weapon in Black Ops 4. I just wish we had those as well. But I'm liking Blackout a lot, and let me know in the comments below what mode are you playing the most. I seriously believe that Blackout has a lot of potential. I really hope they keep updating this mode more and more, and I really hope that going into the future we get unique Blackout camos. Doesn't have to be a lot, could be just one or two camo per weapon. That would be so good. Like let's say every week we get one unique camo for, let's say, the Rampart, you know what I mean, and then the next week after we get another unique camo for the Titan and things like that. That would be just so good, and it would add a lot to the game. Now this is one half of the update. Now the second half will get you wild, and now prepare, we're gonna nosedive into this one, because obviously we got some cat stickers here. We also got tiger stickers. They are on 50% off. Let me check what else is on 50% discount now. For sure, with the Christmas update, we got the Radical. That's the first time I ever seen them include Radicals in the Blackjack shop. It was for 100 Call of Duty points, but damn, son. Now they are for 50 Call of Duty points. Oh, man, the discount is just crazy. We also got this outfit for 400 points or Call of Duty points. I'm kind of glad that they got something going on because the camo looks good, but I don't think I'm going to buy this one. 400 Call of Duty points, just a lot, but then they also put my boy Takio on 400 Call of Duty points. I'm looking at my Call of Duty points because I spent 600 on Richtofen and 800 on Takio, but I don't see my 400 Call of Duty points back. So basically anyone who purchased Takio with their mystery box Call of Duty points, because I did got some COD points with the mystery box, they pretty much got on. I believe that Prestigious Key put out a tweet earlier today, and I guess he deleted that, but he put it out once again. And you can see the replies here. People are mad, people throwing salt, people throwing no one throwing poogers in the chat, that's all I know. And the thing that got a lot of people salty was this boy right here in the special loaders. Now I myself was really thinking hard. I was like, all right, so 50% discount, that means that, hey, poogers in the chat, maybe yes, maybe not, I'm gonna go in the special loaders. You know, I saw this camo by the name of Cypher, I guess I'll be able to buy that. But check this out, it is at 700 Call of Duty points still. I guess Activision sold these skins a lot more than the character skins in the Blackjack shop, so they were like, alright, so we're gonna maximize profits, this is the end of the year, our stock fell, we gotta make a comeback, we gotta get people salty, we gotta get people hooked on that, you know what I mean. But man, if the Cypher skin was for 350 Call of Duty points, I guess I would've bought it, because it also comes out with a cat sticker. Obviously that shit is important. I feel like there is a lot of missed opportunities with these updates. We could have got snow in the playable areas in Blackout. We could have even got Santa hats. I mean, can you imagine Santa hat in Blackout? You can throw that on Scarlet. Oh damn, son, that would have been so good. We could have got something else as well, maybe even Nuketown 24/7. I personally am odd without having double tier, because obviously they cut it down from 200 to 100 tiers now, so I guess you know what I mean. I'm personally in the very middle. If we got it, then whatever. If we don't have it, whatever, I don't really mind that. But the Santa had on Scarlet, that would have been so good during the holiday season. But guess what, man, we didn't got anything of substance yet. But I guess in 2019 we're gonna see a lot of content heavy updates, and I really hope we do. But hey, check out some other videos on the screen, like and subscribe for more, and this is Skizzle disappointed once again, and I will see you in the next one.